gentlemen.
Excuse us, General Burnside. General Hancock has some information you may find useful.
Yes, General Hancock. A pleasure. Sumner, come. We have visitors.
Sir, General Hancock reports the river can be forded the short way upstream. There'd be no difficulty crossing. With your permission, we could move right away.
General Hancock, I certainly appreciate your efforts at reconnaissance, but this possibility has been considered and rejected. The pontoons will be here any time now, and then we'll be able to cross, well, not only the men, but the wagons and supplies as well. It would be foolhardy to send the men without the wagons, without the big guns.
Excuse me, General, but am I correct in my observation that there's little force opposing us across the river?
Yes, General, you are absolutely correct. For once, we seem to have caught old Bobby Lee by surprise.
Well then, sir, if I may suggest, isn't it possible General Lee's moving this way? Certainly, he's aware of our intentions. If we could occupy the town with infantry, it would make our job much easier when the bridges do arrive, sir.
Yes, General, that's risky, I'm afraid. Those men could be cut off. In this weather, my lord, it snows one day, melts the next. The river could rise unexpectedly. It will be best, I assure you, if we wait until the entire army can cross together.
General Burnside, if we don't cross the river very soon, I'm confident General Lee will make every effort to stop us. He's not going to let us move toward Richmond unopposed. Where are General Jackson's forces now? Shouldn't we make some attempt to occupy Fredericksburg and possibly the heights beyond now, while we have it for the taking?
Please, allow me, sir, to at least send General Hancock's division across the river. Surely they can carry enough supplies with them, and the artillery from this side can protect them against any advance by Lee.
Gentlemen, we will cross this river when the bridges arrive and not before. You must understand, I do not have the luxury of deviating from the larger plan. The President has approved my strategy, and I shall stick to it. Once this army is across the river, we will advance on Richmond in force. We must not allow him the luxury of attacking us as divided and separated units as he has done in the past. And I will not make the same mistake as my predecessors. So no, General Hancock. You will hold your division on this side of the river until the pontoons are in place and the entire army crosses together. An irresistible, impregnable force.
They've occupied all the buildings along the riverfront. Our boys will be lining up those pontoon bridges through a hail of lead. Once across, the Rebs are sure to make us pay for every block. Beyond the town is the canal, which cuts across this open field, a field we'll have to cross to reach their entrenchments on Maury's Heights. Another difficult obstacle in the face of artillery fire.
Down to our left, we could push through. Turn Jackson's lines, push him back, trap Longstreet on top of the hill, surround him. It's possible.
Turn Jackson's lines. No, General, we'll meet them head on, and it will be a bloody mess. We'll march up to that hill over there, and we'll eat their artillery fire all the way across this field. But the important thing is we'll be able to look at ourselves in the mirror and say we're good soldiers. We did what we were told. And if we're not successful, we can say, well, it was a good plan, but there were contingencies. And you, General, can go back to your hometown and tell the families of your men they died doing their duty.
The Rebs have fortified the high ground upriver. And anyway, there are strong currents and obstacles to a crossing there. Below Fredericksburg, the river's too wide, and our earliest forces are clear down to Port Royal. Fredericksburg is now the only place we can cross. If Burnside doesn't cross here, he might as well resign.
That wily gray fox has outmaneuvered our command again. And there's going to be hell to pay.